So it is 9:23 Friday, May 18th, and y'all are probably like, I don't even want to watch her videos anymore, like she fell off, and you know, all these different things. And honestly, I did fall off. I'm straightening my hair while I talk to y'all, so don't mind if I look super super crazy. But you know, sometimes life happens where you have to step aside and figure out everything that's going on in your life first before you continue on with things that aren't a priority in your life. And honestly, YouTube has not been a priority. Is this hot? Has not been a priority for me compared to everything that has been going on. So I stepped away for, it feels like months, but it really hasn't been months. I stepped away, I'm using a cheese straightener, by the way. But I stepped away because so many series of events happened. Like, I have a disease called endometriosis that I found out I had in January. And so, I've kind of been dealing with that, and it's a very painful disease. It's very, well, they say it's rare, but 1 out of 10 women have it, and you may even have it and you don't even know. But I've been dealing with that on top of dealing with endo. If you see my lace, y'all, it's just because this wig is not laid. I'm not even gonna lie. But you may see some straps, I don't really care. But I've been dealing with that, and to have a disease, like to live with a disease, taking medication every day for a disease that is uncurable, it's really hard, like to go through like pain constantly, fatigue, moodiness, like it's really hard. And it's something that, God forbid, can maybe be infertile, you know? And I'm just gonna keep saying God forbid for that, because I have faith that Troy and I will have beautiful, beautiful children after we're married and after our wedding and everything, you know, a year or two after. So I have faith in that. Now I have faith in vitro. And we're gonna make it work. And then after we have the desired amount of children, I'm gonna get a hysterectomy. So I may have a hysterectomy before I'm even 30. Like, that's one of the ways that slows down endo. Just getting rid of everything, you know, living a better life. And it's better that way. So that's one of the things that I have been dealing with. Another thing is my mom has had 2 major surgeries in which I became her nurse for, you know? And one of her first surgery, she actually had heart surgery. Not open heart, but they had to like go in there because she gets really bad palpitations. She was born with a heart murmur. She gets really bad palpitations. And she's been getting this episode like where it feels like a heart attack, you know? And the only reason why she had to have that is because she had to have another surgery for her boob because they found a tumor in there. Thank God it's benign, but it could have turned into a cancerous tumor. And so she had to be cleared to have the surgery, like to make sure her heart was strong enough to have that surgery. And thank God she was cleared, and thank God everything is okay. Thank God, like, now her tumor is out of her boob. But just to know, like, all of these things are going through, like, all of these things are happening to someone so close to you. Like, my mom is literally my best friend. We have our ups and downs, like, you know, little petty arguments here and there. But what mother-daughter relationship isn't like that, you know? So then that's what I had to deal with. And then, after all of that, I mean, this isn't the worst. This is actually probably like the best that's happened. Oh no, I'm skipping something else. So then I went to the eye doctor thinking, because every time I go to the doctor, any doctor, it's always bad news. But when you go to the eye doctor, you're not expecting anything bad. And they thought that I was developing this disease, I forgot what it's called, but it causes legal blindness by the time you're 40. My mom's calling, hold on. So I literally straightened one whole side talking to my mother, but I forgot what I was saying. Oh, so they thought that I had this disease that causes you to be legally blind by the age of 40. Like, I'm literally going through it this year, like literally. But is that straight enough? I don't think so. Hopefully it doesn't get humid. But because they saw a picture of my eye, I'm gonna insert it, but if I forget, let me pull it up. Okay, so this is what my left eye looked like, right? Super healthy. Then this is my right eye. Like the whole right of it, is that the right side? Yeah, the whole right side of it is like dead. Like, let me zoom in so y'all can see. See, like that was crazy. But like, for some reason, that news didn't really like bother me. I think it's just because I've been going through literally so many different things that I'm just like, what else? What else, God? Give it to me. Make me a stronger person. Like, that's, like, through the whole time, like, even my sister was like, I'm so proud of you. Like, you're such a strong person. I don't know how you're dealing with this with a smile on your face. But it's really because at least I'm not hearing news that, oh, I have, I don't know, something, and I only have like 6 days to live, like, you know. At the end of the day, I'll still be able to live. So that just made me feel like I need to make more of an impact in my life on other people, and that is something that I really want to do. And like, going through everything that I go through, I feel like I have so much to share with people, and I'm just not being consistent with it. And that was why I like had a major break when I first started YouTube, was because of inconsistency, and then I just fell off. But like, this time I fell off because of legit life stuff happening, you know. And so that was something major. But conclusion of my eye is that, oh, that's why I'm having hard times, because I didn't even pin this up. But the conclusion for my eye is that that I've had 4 concussions in the past, you know? And so my eye is damaged from my concussions. And so that makes me feel like scared, mainly because I don't want to be like those people with the concussions that end up killing like their whole family and then killing themselves, you know. Like, I want, like, if I ever get to that point, put me in a nursing home. You have this on camera. Put me in a freaking nursing home and show me this video, and I just have to know that, okay, I said it, just put me in a nursing home. But it has to be like proof that I'm crazy, because I know you can't diagnose it until, like, you know, you die. But there has to be some sort of proof, like legitimate proof. I'm not even really straightening my hair really good. I'm probably gonna go over it again because I'm gonna shoot a get ready with me video. I'm literally just updating y'all until it's time for me to go to the mall, because the mall by me, the Sephora, has Lily lashes still, and I'm so excited because I have been waiting for Lily lashes to get into going to Sephora. But because I've been going through so many different things, I feel like there was something else that I had to tell y'all. I went over my mom's surgery. I went over, oh, so then after my mom's last surgery, not even a full week later, I got the flu. And not only did I get the flu, but I got laryngitis. This is why I kind of still sound sick, because this is all like happening one after the other after the other after the other after I posted my last video, that y'all are just like, where are you? Like, you just went MIA. And so I got the flu, then I got laryngitis, and then just when I was able to go back to work and like start my life, I got pink eye. So I don't have the flu anymore. I took all of the medication and the antibiotics and like the Tamiflu and whatever else they give you. And so I don't have the flu anymore. I am still getting over like the laryngitis though. So my voice sounds off sometimes, not all the time, but like sometimes. And what else? Oh, and I don't have pink eye, but I didn't even get to use a medication for it because my pharmacy, I'm not gonna say their name because they're big, but my pharmacy didn't have it ready until yesterday before I went to the movies. And it's just like, I've had this for like a good minute, and I've been waiting on my antibiotics, my antibiotic eye drops. And you guys just have it ready? Like, what if my eye fell out? Like, I know that wouldn't happen, but what if it did, you know? So they texted me yesterday saying, your prescription is ready to be picked up. And that was so annoying. My mom still thinks that I should get it, which I will in case like my eye gets sick again. But I will definitely be getting the flu shot every year, because that was the first time I've ever had the flu. So everything that happened was so unexpected because it's something that doesn't really happen to me, you know? Except like endo, like I've been dealing with endo for a while and they just gave me excuses like, oh, it's just a cyst, oh, you just have really bad periods, oh, this and that. And if you don't know what endo is and you want me to make a separate video on that, comment down below and let me know. And like, if you want to know like how long I've been dealing with it, like the full details, how it feels, stuff like that, like really comment down below, because I really don't mind sharing details. Like, that's something that I've always been like. I've always been an open book, which is why I don't mind sharing why I've been MIA, and at least you guys know that it's not like a BS story, you know? Like, it's legit. So because I'm filling you guys in, this is gonna be a super long vlog, but I kind of want to make my vlogs like 30 minutes long. If y'all think that's too long, let me know. But I kind of want to make it like a TV show. Either 30, I feel like 30 minutes is enough. And it will start Fridays, because I don't know. It's gonna start Fridays and Sundays. Be posted on like Thursday. I don't know, maybe Tuesday or Thursday. In which I will be posting Tuesdays and Thursdays on here. And I do have a blog called The Style and Brand that I will be posting on Tuesdays and Thursdays there as well. So I will put the link down below. So please subscribe to my blog. Has like 800 something subscribers, and I just want more subscribers. It's really about style, fashion, because I realized YouTube, I do more makeup stuff when I'm more of like a fashion girl. Like, I don't get me wrong, like I love makeup, but my blog is where I could really show off my fashion. And because I noticed that my fashion videos don't do as well as my beauty videos here on YouTube. And so I just want to be able to showcase both styles, and I realized that my fashion posts do really well on my blog. So it's about style, and then it's also about branding yourself, branding your business. It's about different things, and I also offer online personal shopping as well, if you guys want to take advantage of that. And I do it for an affordable price, so don't worry. But yeah, that is my whole life update. So I'm about to get into the rest of this vlog. I'm going to the mall, so that way I can get my Lily lashes. Then I'm going to go get a gift well, go to Costco to get a gift for Angelica, my friend. She's moving to Atlanta with her boyfriend, and so I just wanted to get her something, and we're gonna go have a sushi lunch date because her boyfriend flies in later. He already lives in Atlanta, so he flies in later so that way he could drive her car down. And it's gonna be so sad. Like, I'm not gonna be like seeing her anymore. We used to go to work, we worked together, and it's gonna be so sad. But I'm happy for her, so I'm not gonna be sad about it. I'm so happy for her because she really gets to start her life and really start living her dream. And that's all I want for my friends. So there's no reason for me to be sad. Like, if I'm sad for her leaving, I feel like that's selfish. Like, I know, like, you're entitled to be sad and stuff, but I just see it as being selfish because I can't be sad about her going to live out her dream, you know? That's just how I view it. So I am headed to the mall so I can go to Sephora. I wanna go to Sephora, then I wanna go to Aldo to see if I see any more cute like spring like bags. Before I used to buy like designer bags, but I have really been loving like Aldo bags so much. And then it's kind of cold. And then I am going to go look for some clothing pieces. And then after that, I have to go to Costco to get Angelica's gift. Focus.
Why isn't it focusing? Oh, I think I accidentally zoomed. There we go.
So I'm headed to Jackson's Bistro. Angelica's already there. She's usually late. I'm usually going on time, so this is weird. But I just filmed my get ready with me, which is why I'm late. This is the outfit. And I'm so cute.
Oh, no. Oh God, that's not
this is Angelica.
That's your other one, right?
Yeah, oh, okay. I'm not walking around with that other one.
That's the
same one. But she's leaving. Do you have any last words for Florida?
I'm not gonna miss this heat. Well, actually, it's gonna be hot there too.
Not that long though. Like, you have seasons.
Any last words? I'm gonna miss the beaches. Isn't that crazy that I never go to the beach? But now that I know that there's no beaches.
There's man-made beaches.
Yeah, and they're so far.
Oh, they are?
They're like in Savannah.
Oh.
Other parts of Florida. So I'm gonna miss the water.
Aww, water.
And I'm gonna miss my friends. The only two that I have.
Stop, you have more. Last time you came at like four.
I have a queen. No, but those, I forget.
Don't say nothing on camera. You don't want to say.
No, I mean, they know. Y'all know the stuff.
You're like, what's her name? Which reality TV show? Those are not my friends. They're just people that I know. I don't know you yet. Who says that?
Who says
it's a black reality TV show. I'll get to it when I get to it.
But yeah, like, my friends are you and Mariah.
Oh, okay.
Other people, like, I was getting to know them. They're cool, don't get me wrong.
But they didn't make it to that level yet.
Yeah.
Now
lashes
they
are popping though.
I know, it's the Lily ones. Wait till I wear the A&M ones.
This is the last time I'm gonna see Angelica for like, I'm gonna say a month.
Probably a month, yeah. Month and a half.
I'm gonna miss my baby girl. Look how beautiful she is.
Oh, stop. No, I'm
But she has to go get her man
from the airport.
So that
wedding.
So that he can take her away from me.
It's hot as hell. But
it is.
You know, I'm sorry, mom, for rushing that.
Bye.
I love you.
I love you too.
Be safe. FaceTime me. Text me. Whatever.
This is proof. I will text you. I will respond to your text messages. I will call you.
I need a head
if
on.
I don't, sue me.
I ain't got nothing but sue me.
How fast can I sue? Like how, like 30
well,
minutes?
You, no, you gotta.
When we walk away?
No, you gotta give me some time.
You gotta give me some time. When I get in the car.
Because when I get everything situated, you're coming over to see everything.
I mean, you don't even gotta get it situated. Like, I could come help you get it situated. I already told you that.
You did tell
but
me.
But then that. I was like, oh, I can come help you. Oh, my mom is helping
well,
you.
Well,
I was like,
because my,
I'm just trying to help.
I don't want to give my mom's job away. Like, I have to, you know.
First off, I actually have this job for her.
I'm kidding.
That's true.
But your mother birthed you.
You know, you can't.
Even though she came out of my vagina.
On that note, goodbye.
Aww.
I'm going to go pick up my baby now.
I'm gonna record you walk away.
Ew, no.
That's awkward. Zooms in. I don't even know how to zoom in on this thing.
Bye.
Be careful.
This is like the only thing worse. I mean worse. This is the only bad thing when you go out to a late lunch, you get stuck in 5 o'clock traffic. Like this is bad.
So I'm back home.
Left the line on by accident.
But. Well, it's such a bittersweet thing, like to know that she's leaving. Oop, let me face the light. To know that she's leaving, but it's for such like a good reason. She's gonna go live with the love of her life, and she's going to, you know, fulfill her dreams in like the beauty world. And Ellen is just the perfect place to do that. Like to do beauty, do fashion, like. For a woman of color, like, it's such a good place to do that. So I'm really happy for her, and I'm gonna miss her, but I'm gonna see her, and I love her. I love you, Angelica.
He's nice, but he's real quiet and keeps himself. He doesn't talk to very many people. He'll be walking around with his trench coat on, and head comes in, doesn't say anything.
Trench coat. On his t-shirt, he also posted a photo of this black duster jacket with Nazi, communist, fascist, and religious.
So it's Saturday, what day is it? May 19th? And we are on our way to run some errands, but I feel so bad because we left Noah there and he was crying. This is the first time we're leaving him in the apartment.
That's why I need another dog so he's not alone.
That's why we need a house to have the kind of dog you want. Because you want a bigger dog.
I mean, it's gonna be a puppy.
But it's gonna grow fast. Those dogs grow in 6 months.
Yeah, what is that? It's May. 6 months?
Did you lotion your face?
No.
Okay. So today we are going to go get Troy some running sneakers.
What are we doing?
Troy's getting Davion a birthday gift, which is his little brother.
Yes, I have to get running shoes. Look for some gift. Probably, I forgot my piece. Probably, get a work pants or something, work shirt. And then slide to the pawn shop real
Why?
Quick. See what computers they have, it's by the mall. See what computers they have and other stuff they have there. And then,
my mom told you to do that?
Nah, I just know there's a good one. The one across you from Gyros?
Oh.
That's a good one. I'm gonna check that one out. So I'm gonna head to do that stuff, and then after that, we'll go look at the house.
Yeah, we're gonna go look at a model home. Well, two, because you wanted to see the one that your family said was really nice.
Yeah, yeah.
The one you told me?
Oh, yeah, I know.
Yeah. Oh, okay. It's right there. It's right by the Cal Atlantic one. So we're gonna look at two, then, and then Troy has to drop off Davion's gift. And yeah. Let me see you bite it. That's a big old bite.
Yeah.
So it's Sunday and we are at Costco and he can't make up his mind about what he wants.
Can you get off my damn shoes?
I wasn't even on your shoes. That's crazy because you stepped on my foot. So if you stepped on my foot, how would I be on your shoe? Buttermilk, there's no buttermilk.
It's just
okay, hurry up, it's cold. If it's just homestyle, take it out. Anyways. Kisses. Hi, little baby. Hi. Hi. Hi.